Hey everybody, real quick before the video begins, I just wanted to pop on and let you know the video you're about to watch right now was actually recorded live. In fact, all reactions that I do are done live. I do it this way so I can have a better understanding of the song I'm about to react to and a deeper context. If you'd like to share any music with me, we got a community Discord link down below I highly recommend checking out, and that's really the only way to do it. So if you're on Discord, check out that link down below and you can share some awesome music with us. If you'd like to join a live show, the Twitch link is down there as well. It's absolutely free, it's a blast, and just a great place for music enthusiasts to come together and get a broader and a deeper and a more educated understanding of the music they love and enjoy. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you do, please consider liking and subscribing.
Hopefully you guys are cool that every week I take requests from you guys, and this week I wanted to do my own reaction, and I've been kind of putting this one off for a little while. I know that it's kind of has sensitive material in it, and it's kind of a heavy song. And I've been kind of putting it off. You got to kind of mentally prepare yourself for these things. And I figured it'd be better to do it live with everybody else. I'm working today, too. Well, this isn't work. This is fun for me. So today I want to do something for myself. Hopefully you guys are cool with it. I'm going to do one quick reaction and then I'm going to I'll go to everybody else's pick. But there's been a video that I've been kind of dying to see. And is this one right over here? It's a brand new one from August D. It dropped 9 days ago, so I'm way behind the party on this one. I meant to react to it last week, but, you know, it's just, I don't know, with, like, sensitive music topics and, you know, a song like this, I wanted to kind of, I don't know, just chill with the album for a little while, relax with it, really absorb some of the messages and everything. And I know this is a heavier one, and I figured it'd be better to do it live here with everybody. So if you guys are cool with it, I'm gonna do it here now live with you guys. And oh yeah, there's a trigger warning. Yeah, I think somebody said there's like a it says it right. Yeah, there it is right here. The following content may contain suicide or self-harm topics. So if you're sensitive to that kind of thing, be warned. So yeah. It's heavy but beautiful. Well, we're gonna find out right now. I like to do a bit of a deep dive on these videos, and I know there's probably gonna be some hidden Easter eggs and stuff. So I'll probably spend a few minutes talking about this, and then we'll get right to the list for Live Request Wednesday. All right, we've waited long enough. Let's do it. All right, am I even allowed to watch this? What the heck? Hold on. Will it not let me watch it? Am I not an adult? I wish to understand and proceed. Okay, here we go. Okay. I thought I was like, you know what, Jim, you can't handle it. Oh, shit. Shit, I know where this is going. Oh, shit. Okay, I had a feeling it was going to there. The injury from his shoulder. That's when he was like a delivery guy. And it was very early in his career before really even took off. But yeah, he messed himself up pretty bad and it was pretty traumatic. I can't believe they're showing that. Yikes. All right, so it starts off kind of ominous, him in this dark room with his random door. Almost doesn't even look like him. Oh my god, dude. Is he gonna cut himself? What the shit? It's like he's trying to like reach his sleeping self. There's two different versions of him. Dude, this is dark. Okay, so he gave himself that scar. Oh, shit. Okay. Okay. Teasing him. This room is teasing him. Okay, I got a bit of a theory here. I think the room is supposed to represent his own mind, like he's trapped in his own head. And the getting out of the door is like traveling to a different version of himself or possibly his memories or something. But he's locked in this room with like this dark room, which I think is supposed to symbolize like dark thoughts or, you know, possibly all the darker shit that he's talking about in context of this song, you know, like the tragic and, memories that are just kind of like, you know, really, really stuck with this dude. And I think that's what this is supposed to symbolize. And it's like the door is almost like teasing him. He's like lackadaisically walking towards it and it closes shut. There's also some light shining through it, but this is kind of cool. It's dark for sure, but the symbolism is pretty much on the nose, I think. Just taking pills. What the hell was that? Maybe the room is supposed to symbolize like him being kind of like frustrated by these thoughts and these memories, and he's trying to like go back in time, but he can't. It looks like there's a lot of drugs going on. Like he's just taking a lot of pills, but then it's switched over. It's for something else. Okay, it's a lot of flash stuff. I'm gonna try to pause right on it. Oh, damn it, I just missed it. There it is. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. I can't believe I got that frame. Holy shit. Okay, so he's taking pills and then he switches to nuts, or I think they're almonds actually. Which again, I think, I don't know, maybe this is symbolization of some sort of like positive change instead of getting off of drugs and moving on to the almonds. Then the possibility of the medulla or however you say it, like the shape of it is supposed to be an almond. Yeah, so this is definitely symbolizing something here. He just keeps reliving these traumatic moments. He's trapped, yeah. Like reliving these traumatic moments over and over in his mind and like questioning himself, like, did I make the best choice? Did I do the right thing? And like, you know, even for things that he definitely couldn't have changed or would have had no impact on, you know, obviously like, you know, the heart surgery right away with his mother the month that he was born, and like the liver disease or cancer that his dad had, like there's just nothing you can do about that. But he's definitely questioning his past here, and it's pretty cool that it's done symbolically in the video. Yeah, he's begging for it. He's having a harder time like even reaching the door at this point. Wait, did he see himself? It looks like he sees something here, like he's grasping something. Miami Dala, He like gets right off the moped and is like running away from the accident. Like, I think he's fantasizing if he could like go back in time and change something, and like this is what he would have done maybe. Oh shit, he's on the other side of the door. I get it. Oh no. Oh, but ultimately he can't get through because it's just the way it is. Holy shit. Yeah, this is jam-packed full of symbolism and in darkness. And a lot of it's right in the nose, and a lot of it's like minor, but like the flashing, the imagery and stuff. Yeah, dude, it's a tale of struggle, and it's his tale. And I mean, obviously he'd like to go in the past and warn himself and be like, hey, don't do this or change this. And he's questioning his own thought process and making sure that he made the right thing, but the right choices. But you know, you can't go back in the past. But the shitty thing about this thing in the back of your head is it's the Amygdala. God, I'm so sorry, I'm butchering this. I'm still butchering it. I'll never say it right. The shitty thing about it is it's like a defense mechanism. Like, it's supposed to store traumatic memories, and it's basically doing that to warn you. It's warning you that you not to do that shit again. You know, if you touch a hot stove and it burn your hand, like that's, it stores in there. Like, hey, don't touch that hot stove. You know. But it can also be debilitating as well. And, you know, you can focus on it and get trapped in this one sense of your brain. And I think that's what this room is supposed to symbolize. That's what the darkness is over here. I like how the weather is kind of similar between the two versions of himself, the younger self and himself now. It's kind of sad. You know, the video is shot beautifully and everything. But at the same time, yeah, it's definitely dark. It's definitely sad. This is the darkest video I don't know. He's been doing some dark and intense videos lately. But yeah, dude, overall, man, it's beautiful. It's a beautiful song. And like, I went over this in my album reaction, talked a lot about the production and the music and all that stuff. So I don't want to get too much into that. I want to talk more about the actual symbolism and how this video was done. And for the most part, yeah, I really do like it. I'm surprised that he showed some of, you know, the more intense and traumatic parts of his life, like that accident that really fucked him up, you know. And they show that over and over and over again, and I think that's supposed to symbolize he's trapped in this part of his brain, and it's just replaying it over and over, and he's driving himself insane thinking about, could I have changed that or done something better? But, you know, on a high note of this song, you know, it does have a sense of hope and you know, like, beauty to it. The fact that, like, he knows he's a smart dude, that he can't go back in the past and change anything, but at the same time, you know, it definitely is dark, but there is a message of there's a light at the end of the tunnel kind of thing here. And you are the way you are from the choices that you make. And you just gotta, you know, hopefully make the right ones, or at least learn from them. Yeah, dude, overall, beautiful video. Jesus. Suga does not miss. Augusty, this album was something else. D-Day is, I think, his crown achievement. I think every one of his albums got better from every single one of them. And I know this is the end of the trilogy here, and you know, it's kind of sad, but I'm excited to see what he does next, honestly. I'm excited to see where he goes with music and what he does with solo music and everything from there. But yikes. More intense stuff, dude. I was not expecting this crazy of an album. I really wasn't. I was expecting to, like, you know, dig certain parts of it and, you know, get excited about some of the production. But, like, the messages, the music, the production, like, everything is just so top-notch. Like, I'm so proud. Badass, dude. Badass. All right, let's check out chat. I probably got so much wrong on that. I was trying not to pay attention to chat as I was talking there because I didn't want to I didn't want to throw myself off, but I probably butchered that. Let's see. Cabbage Dynamite. It's an almond shape and named after the Greek word for almond, and also the book Sun Wan Poon that works for that. So the theory is that he was eating almonds. Oh, because of the book? Okay, I thought it was legit, like a shape thing. Yeah, but yeah, so Miss JJ says it's an almond-shaped part of the brain. So, I mean, it's anybody's game. I mean, I'm sure, like, DKDK will do, like, an explanation video. I'll check out later. Jaceel says, I think what makes this video darker is that it's largely based in reality. Hagam is violent, but they're pretty sure Yoongi hasn't stabbed people with chopstick. Yeah, I mean, we don't know for sure, but I'm pretty sure he probably hasn't murdered a man. But only time will tell. Only time will tell. Oh, my God. I'm sorry, was the buffering bad? Is it, were we messing up? Oh, he said, oh God, Clemmy has proven me right. Of course, it's multi-layered nursery. Like, nothing is, you know. Yeah. All right. Cool. All right. Well, guys, thanks for letting me do that. I would have much rather do that live and experience it with everybody here than just, like, sit by myself and just, like, go lay down on the asphalt after, you know? So I appreciate you guys. Let me have a minute there to do that. But now it's time to get to what everybody else has picked for today.